everyone, it's your friend Thick Noodles, and welcome to my Let's Play, and I'm here in my XP farm, and I'm really not trying to get XP, I'm trying to get items, and I'll show you guys why in a minute, but I learned this trick from one of Etho's videos, and it has to do with your looting sword, and this is only looting two, but basically, if I throw this at these guys, and I switch to my looting sword quickly enough before they die, I will get the effect as if I hit them with my looting sword. So as you guys can see, my looting sword is almost gone. So this will save my looting sword and I'll get the drops, which is what I want. So here we go, 3, 2, 1, boom. And it should give me a bunch of extra drops by doing that. And yeah, so look at the drops I'm getting. I'm getting a lot, look at that. Oh my God, a power 2-punch-1 bow that's almost completely full. That's my own bow. But as you guys can see, I'm getting good drops and things like that. So it does actually work, and it doesn't use the durability on your sword. I can't see anything, although I do. All right, I'll let you guys kill each other. And you know, I've noticed I'm in 164 now, and I've gone and explored my witch hut. Haven't explored the nether yet, but I have noticed that there are a lot more skeletons spawning with iron armor. Let's turn this off. At least, see, look at that guy. He's got an iron chestplate. I saw full irons on full iron skeleton before. It's kind of crazy. So anyway, what I'm trying to get here in the drops, guys, are bones. Funny enough, I know it's a weird thing to want, but I do want the bones, and the reason for that is for trading with my village. Will you guys stop coming? With my villagers for emeralds. So I've been trying my best to get more bone meal so I can make more wheat. I've gone through all of the bones, and you guys know how many chests full of bones I had. Well, they're gone. So, you know, these power twos are so run down. I'm not gonna like, okay. I could waste XP on those, but I'm keeping those. And I've done it a couple times and gotten some enchanted bows that I'll probably combine. Fire protection one. I got a really good pair of pants. It was like protection 3 pants. They were gold, but still, I mean, protection 3 is pretty cool. Look at that. Fire protection 1, feather falling 1. I'll keep those. Look, see, an iron chest plate they dropped. That's cool. Protection 2, thorns 1. But yeah, so I'm getting a lot of interesting drops by doing this too. Just, I don't know, it's kind of cool to look at them. What else? But I'm also picking up quite a few bones this way, although I would have liked more. So, let me go ahead and clear this out the rest of... Oh, feather falling 3 full. Look at that. No durability taken away. Sweet. Nice. All right. Sweetness. Okay. So, yeah. Where are those pants? I think it was pants. Protection 3 leggings right there. Look at that. So, what I'm going to do is I'm going to head back... Well, I'm going to go and fill this up a little bit more. It's actually getting full again, so I can use this. But yeah, I'm gonna fill this up, and then I'll come back with you guys when I am at the village, and you can see I have a bunch of random stuff in my inventory, which I'll explain once I get to the village. So I'll be right back, guys. Okay, guys, we are back at the village, and well, the reason I need that bone meal is because of this fellow right here. After I did my video, I did some trading and stuff, and I was getting everything set up, and funnily enough, Doc M made a video about villager trading like 2 or 3 days ago. So I went and watched that, and he introduced the concept, at least to me, of the perfect villager. And it got me to thinking about the villagers that I had put in here, like this guy. And he is the least perfect villager you can find, because this is the ideal trade that I want, wheat for emeralds at this point. And you don't want that the first trade or the second trade or the third trade. And his problem is, well, he's got fish for emeralds. That trade is awful because 9 fish takes about 5 minutes. So, you know, each time you want to unlock it, you got to have 9 fish and you got to cook them. Not a good trade. This guy right here, same deal. And I didn't even get very far past his, but anyway, the perfect villager is, well, this guy, I call him the almost perfect villager. And what he means is you get through all these trades, and each time you do one, so if I did 10 cooked fish, it would unlock the next one, and then it would unlock the next one. And sometimes you have to do it 2 or 3 times. That's an awful trade. But anyway, we got to the point where it was 19 wheat and 1 emerald, and I traded him like 6 or 7 times, and he got through every time. I was like, yes, I found the perfect villager. Now, the perfect villager means that this would be the final trade, so that if it ever locks itself out, because like I told you guys before, if one of the trades locks, you go to the last trade, make that trade, and it'll unlock all the previous trades. But if it's the last trade and you lock it, you just do the trade again, it unlocks it. So it'll never, basically it'll never lock that last trade. So I thought I had him, but turned out this is his last trade. And that's okay, because 1 emerald for 8 cookies, fairly easy if I just go and grab, you know, I'm going to get emeralds from here anyway. I can waste 1 emerald and then unlock it again, do it 3 or 4 times, and then unlock it again 3 or 4 times, etc. So he's almost perfect. I have not found the perfect farmer, and these are farmer villagers. I went through a bunch of them and couldn't find one, so we'll have to breed more at some point to get the perfect villager. But as you guys can see, random stuff in my inventory, I had to kill a ton of chickens and trade for chickens and melons and apples and cookies. I mean, like, look at, I got cookies, I got bottles of enchanting, a bunch of shears, flint and steel, bookshelves, ingots, clocks. Look at all the clocks I have. These are the things that they like. They like to trade all these random things. I spent probably about 6 or 7 hours collecting resources and doing the trading with these guys, trying to find the perfect villager, and I got close. So that's good enough for now. I got really tired of it, and I was like, you know what? I'm going to make an episode. I mean, look at all the apples I have now. Look at that. It's like over 100 apples that I traded for. But anyway, look at... So now that I got the almost perfect villager, we've got quite a few emeralds in our stash here. So cool, and a lot of cookies. Although I thought... Well, I guess... What I was going to say, I thought that the wheat would give me a lot more emeralds, but I did have to do a lot of weird trading to try and find this guy finally, so I wasted a lot of emeralds during that time. So, anyway, we're getting there with our marketplace, and I wanted to go over to this guy right here, make a nice little trade. Hey, buddy, I would love that, so let's do that. That's awesome. Sweet, what a deal. I mean, that is sweet. So, let's put those on. And the other ones don't have that great of trades just yet, but we'll get there. So let's put those diamond leggings on. Sweet. Oh, yeah, that looks good. That looks good. I love it. Look at that. Look at those free diamond leggings. I mean, not free, but pretty good deal on those. So, yeah, I mean, and I try to put stairs, like, here to try and get them out. They still just like the pool. This guy's out, at least. Actually... I didn't know there were 5. I thought there were only 4. Now that we've got that, I'm just gonna... Oh, God, all the clocks. I'm gonna have to probably... I don't know. I'm gonna have to figure this out a little bit more and get these guys better. Because there's also a perfect librarian. And the perfect librarian would be this as the last trade, paper to emerald. Then he can set up a sugarcane farm. How did that guy get out of there? He should not be out of there. He should be in the... what are you doing? Which guy are you? Because you should... Ooh, I don't want to lose you. Okay, don't get out, okay? I don't know how you got out of his little pen. I'll put him in there later. But I did a lot of work on the Sky Island as well. I'd say between the last episode and this episode... Probably have gone through, including, let's see, the what do you call it, the XP farm for items and all that stuff. I would say probably about 6 to 8 hours of gameplay, getting resources to trade with the villagers and whatnot. So I also did some work on the Sky Island, and this is not going to be very fun. We're just going to go right through the middle, and I should not have done this at night, but whatever. It is what it is. Creepers, leave me alone, please. So what I did with the Sky Island, I sort of chiseled out, and I expanded a little bit along the bottom, and chiseled out that centerpiece to try and make it look more natural. Now, I had the one thing I didn't do was, and I wish I had, but I sort of, not that I forgot, it's just that I got there and I was just like, you know, I'm not going to start taking things out and replacing things yet. I don't know why I didn't grow back. All right, stop it. But one thing that I didn't put any of the ores down or any of that. So it's just stone, but we will replace that. And obviously we'll do that in the cave inside, especially. But we're going to put some on the outside to make it look a little more natural. What is following me? It's those villagers walking around. I thought it was a mob, or a not friendly mob. Now, another thing I did is, I got rid of, okay. So guys, I don't know if I mentioned I'm in 164 and it looks like it like reset everyone for some reason. Like why won't they sit down? I can't control them. They won't sit. Oh my gosh. Okay. This isn't good. Guys, So my dogs are out. This is not good, guys. Yikes. I'm a little worried because I don't want to go up to the Skyland and have them die. Let's go take a nap and I'm going to relog. Be right back, guys. Okay, guys, I relogged and you guys can get a kind of a look at it. Oh, I left a hole there. I didn't mean to do that. But as you guys can see, it looks a lot better. This is kind of what I intended. It's not exactly what I intended, but nonetheless, that's what's going to have to happen. And let's see if they will sit now that I've relogged. Please, please, guys. Oh, bizarre. Where? All right, we're missing. Who do we have? We have Ibokani, we have Naruko 2, where is Okuron? It's really weird, because they were running around. You guys saw it, right? Okuron, where are you? Oh man, did we lose a dog? Wait, there you are. Good, sit. Good dog. Okay, come here, come on. Alright, so, man, I don't know what was going on there. I don't know. First of all, I don't know why they're running around. Second of all, I don't know why I couldn't make them sit. Come on, Okuron. Over here, buddy. Where you at? All right, good boy. All right. Do not want you falling. So, one thing you guys may have noticed is that, and the reason I'm like sighing is because I didn't make a shovel. So, yeah, you guys may have noticed that this is different. I don't know why that grass has not grown back. That is weird. So I got rid of the, that's probably what one of those holes is. Yeah, that's one of the water holes. So I got rid of most of the water holes and I got the one on the side, just to go down. And I was like, oh, I'll just break this water source. And I thought, oh man, I got a much better idea. So my idea was this, it was to make a pond down here for the water to go into. So we can make a pond down here and a pond up there. And I think it'll be really cool. So let's see if we can make it actually fall. I don't know why. I may have to. Oh, you know what I probably have to do? I probably have to stop the water stream and update it so that it goes in there. So let's just get rid of it. Because what's happening now is it's, well, I don't really know what's happening now. It should be. I really don't know what's happening now. I feel like it should be up. Updating properly. Ah, come on. Okay. Here we go. Is that? Yep, that should do it. All right. So we'll ride up the stream. Hey, Peggy. Piggy. I called him Peggy. Peggy. Peggy the pig. And I should be able to pull this water back and then put it back down, and then it'll do what I want it to do. So we'll go on the outside like this. And we'll ride it up, and we'll have some bread while we'll eat a little food while we enjoy the ride. Hey, buddy. So what I think is it should just drop right down there, and then we can sort of once it goes into exactly the hole that we want it to, then we can form the pond around it and put lily pads and stuff and grass around it and cool stuff. And we'll do the same up here. You know, those vines are taking. excessively long to go down. I thought that they would probably be touching the ground by now, which has me a little worried about how that's going to look. But, I mean, they have grown quite a bit. I just thought they would grow faster. Kind of want to make some grow on this side, too. It doesn't make sense that they only come from one side of the island. But still, anyway, here you guys go. You're getting a look at what I did to that thing on the bottom. And I sort of, I mean, I tried my best to make it not look square. It is pretty square, but I did my best to make it not look square. So what do you guys think? Pretty cool, right? I think it is. So anyway, this is, come on, come on, come on. Don't fall. So yeah, all I did was, you know, you guys remember I had the infinite water source here. And all I did was break it. So it just goes over the edge. And what I was thinking, what we could do is sort of, do this a little bit. So we could expand the pond, like expand it into a pond, I guess. So maybe like over here, like that maybe. Yeah, that could work. And it would be like a pond like this, and then it would go off like that. So I need to probably get some more water up here now because I messed that up. But what else were we up here for? Oh yeah, that's where that thing was. We'll just do that. Fine. All right, and what's this? Oh, this is another. Oh yeah, so I left that. That was my way back up. I'm gonna need water to do that. But what I want to do is just close off the bottom. Because it doesn't matter, like, if it's hollow, we won't know the difference, right, guys? Yeah. Okay, so, let's see if we can, oh, we've got ice. We can use ice. Yeah, perfect. That's why I got some ice. Do we have lily pads? Oh, yeah, we do. Sweet. All right. So, what we can do, which is a nice thing with ice, is it turns to source blocks, so you just put it where you want the source blocks to be, and you don't slide off. Oh, wow, how did that happen? I guess it was near the torch. And we'll do that and that. There we go. And we should probably put one here too and there. So this should do what we want it to do, I think. Let's see. We're getting close to finishing this Sky Island, guys. I know it has been a long, long time. Yeah, that looks decent. Yep, I think I want it to come out over here a little bit more, like this maybe. Yeah, I think. Yeah, oh, well, I don't know why I'm putting... Oh, gosh. Sorry about that, guys. I had to... My throat was... Ugh, I don't know. Yeah, I think that kind of works. Although, I'm going to have to pull this tree stump back a little bit. Yep. And I don't really... Ah! Not where I wanted that. Okay, good. Yeah, that's good. All right, so now we'll put down a couple of lily pads. Like here and there. Maybe there. Put one there. Yep. And they're all in a line. That makes a lot of sense. So yeah, that's cool. All right, that looks good. Yeah, I like that. I like that. Do we have any grass that we can put around it? Because this island doesn't have any grass on it. And I'm just working on the details now, guys. Sort of, we don't have much grass, do we? Oh yeah, we do. Just kidding. All right, cool. And if we put some grass around it here, like, there and there. Yeah, see, that's better. That is much better. Okay, so yep, we got that. Now I'm trying to remember if I did anything down here. I don't think I did, but I did finish the, oh yeah, I did actually. Yeah, I so when I was down there, I ended up opening a lot of areas that I didn't mean to open, so I sort of changed the area where the dragon egg is going to be. It's going to be down here in this room, and this is, I can't go any further than these. This will go to the outside if I break any of these blocks. So I have to decorate this room somehow. I want to make it suitable for the dragon egg and make it really nice looking. I can't figure out how yet. it's evading me at this time. And of course, they're going to put auras all around this and make it look more natural, which I've already said. Now, let me go and show you guys what it looks like upstairs with the lighting that I redid. Okay, Optifine keeps... I don't know what's going on, but like... I think I've got to work on my Optifine settings because it keeps crashing on me. I don't know what's going on here, but... We were going up here. I was going to show you guys. I put the lighting in, which is, the redstone lamps with half slabs, and it just lowered the ceiling just a little bit of a half area there. And then we've got the lighting sticking down like that. And I kind of like it that way instead of recessed. I think it's cool. We still need to get the silk touch book so we can put it on shears, and we can put some cobwebs up here to make it look a little bit more rustic. And maybe we'll put some furniture in, but pretty much done here. We got the lighting all set. I like it. Now we need to go check down below on our little pond here. Yeah, this is awesome. I love it. Okay, and it looks like, you know, it looks like it's spreading further than I want it to. I think it's because we sort of relocated the stream with what we did. Yeah. Okay, so let's, I should have a shovel for this, but, I did learn a thing or two about water. So, the reason it's reaching here, I believe, is because it thinks that it's reaching a lower point. Now, with what I think I learned about water, from, my water magic episode. We've got a little bit here. Let's take that down, 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 and down. And we should be able to block off certain areas and then have it become what I want it. Yeah. Okay. So what I want it to do is fall into this thing as if it is, get that, as if it is a pond here. And I don't want it to be, I want this to sort of fall on one side of the pond, but not on the very side. So we want to dig out a little bit more here. Yep, that's where I would want it. Okay. Something like that. Yep. Yeah. And then, and then have it come out a little bit here. Yep. Around this way. Do you guys get the idea? Right. Okay, so we'll dig that a little deeper. Yep. And what we should be able to do here is put, so where's the edge? Okay, so let's see if I do this properly. Yep, okay. So we should be able to stop this all the way around. And once I stop it, it should not want to come, oh, I should go closer. Should not want to come back. Because we should be able to train the water to just go around where it's actually coming down from. I really shouldn't be doing this at night, and I should not have done that. Let's train it again. Okay. And this one's a little bit deep. Let's see if I can. There we go. Sweet. And that is good there. And as you guys can see, what I'm doing is sort of... what I call, I mean, I call it training the water, and I think that's kind of the right terminology. Okay, so we want to train it a little bit further here. And what you want to do is just have the vertical streams if you can manage, which is what I'm trying to do. Come on, don't fail me here. There we go. So we've got vertical, vertical, vertical. All right, everything is vertical. Am I right? What are you doing here? I don't know where you're coming from. Okay, so yeah, that looks pretty good to me. So what we'll do is, let's see. So our pond is gonna be okay. So it needs to go down a level. So we're gonna make sure that we're down deep enough here. It does look like it. Let's get out of the water here. But here we're not deep enough. We need to go down another level here. because, well, we might be okay here, but I'd rather, oop, that's not where I want to do it. I want to be safe. So, yep. And obviously here we're not deep enough because we're at the same level. So we need to dig this all out and make it into our little pond area. We'll do this like this, I guess. Like that. Yep, that should do it. And then we'll have a nice little pond down here and a way to get up and down. However, not the ideal way to get up and down because the nether portal still doesn't work. Although soon, which I'm going to be upgrading to 1.7, probably in the next episode, we will be able to, I guess I can just join it like that. We will be able to make nether portals of like almost any size, which is kind of awesome. So let's see if I break these. We should be able to do this. Yep. Okay, cool. And then, yes. All right, good. So as you guys can see, it looks like it's a waterfall falling into the ground here. And then we can use a bunch of ice and make it into a water pool and then put some lily pads and then we're all set. Let's see. Yeah, okay. I heard you coming. I heard you coming. Don't steal my blocks. I could do this a lot faster if I had a shovel, but I didn't think to bring one, so there's that. Okie dokie, and almost there, guys. Good stuff. Yeah, all right. Come on, get that last little bit down. Oh yeah, this worked well. Yeah, I did learn it. I did learn a thing or two. Although there's a problem, I don't know which one it is, but basically what happened there is it saw, what are you doing with full chain, man? Get out of here. It saw a block lower, or what it thought was a lower water location. These all need to be the same height level. Oh, I see what the problem is. It's not deep enough here, so there. Basically, this area that it's falling onto is not deep enough, so it needs to go deeper. And that should fix that. So we'll just do this and block that back off. Ah, lovely stuff. Okay, there we go. Yep, that looks pretty good. I think it's low enough. Is it low enough? Yeah, they look all low enough. So let's try this again. Oh, geez, I broke it over here. Maybe I didn't learn that much. no, I did. I learned. See, like, I wouldn't have known where to block otherwise to stop this. But I do because I did learn things. Right? Right. Okay. All right, let's do this the right way. Okay, so. And more or less, the best idea is to actually have it be one block. Darn it. One block deeper. And is it? Yeah, it's sort of. Oh, no, it isn't. It isn't. It isn't. It isn't at all. It needs to be one block deeper for everywhere that the water is flowing into. And it isn't. So that's. This will make it so that it won't come out. So now when we drop down a block to the actual level of the pond, The waterfall is falling in one block deeper and it won't be tempted to come out this way. Oh, look, it's turning. Oh, so I didn't expect that to be there. All right, there. It's turning to be a sunshiny day on the noodle planet. There we go. Nice. And finally there. All right, good stuff. Now all we need to do is now, what level? Oh, yeah, right. So this level, we'll just put ice. There we go. And we just fill it with ice, and then we break the ice, and then we have our pond. See, ice is awesome. That's why I grabbed a whole bunch of it with my silk touch pickaxe. And I'll probably grab more at some point, too, just because it's so great to be able to place the water where you want it to go, and then you can just break it. Although I'm running out now, so I'll have to. Wow, and I am unbelievably hungry. Don't know what's going on there. Let me go grab some more ice from my chest up there. I'll be right back. Okay, guys, there was some ice in there, but the actual chest with all the ice is, I think, down below. But this should be enough, although it may not be. Should be enough to do what we want to do here, but, oh man, it's going to be close. Oh yeah, look at that. One to spare. Sweet. Okay, so now we just go and break this. And we've got a nice little pond here. And it should look like a real pond with a waterfall coming into it. Let's see. Yeah, it does. Sweet. Although I'm almost tempted to make it like sort of flow a little bit more. I don't know. Because it does look a little unnatural. I don't know. We'll have to see. But there we go. Sweet, we've got a pond, and now we need some lily pads, and we need the grass to grow back and stuff. And then we can add some tall grass and some flowers, and we'll be all set. Especially if we get 1.7. Oh my gosh, you guys, we can put flower, like all the different flowers and the double tall grass. I'm excited. I really, really want to upgrade, but I have to go and explore my nether so that I don't mess up all my nether fortresses. You have to explore it. So that's a word of advice to anyone who wants to play the snapshot on the existing world. Go in 1.64 and explore any structures like witch huts or nether fortresses, things like that, because they will be ruined and won't work, won't spawn the special mobs if you don't visit them in 1.64 before switching to a 1.7 or even a 1.7 snapshot. You really, really do need to upgrade and visit the areas. Just upgrading isn't actually good enough if you don't. Wow, that does that actually? Oh, that's interesting. Yeah, okay, I didn't even consider that it was hitting a tree. Okay, cool. So we've got our little pond down here, and that is awesome. I love it. We can fish in it and stuff. We'll add some grass around it right now, just to give it a little bit more. Because it looks so like sterile around here, you know, like everything is all flat and green. And okay, I guess it clobbers the grass when you do that. If you put it on one of these, and the grass grows. The short grass grows, it'll get rid of that. I thought I saw that. I thought that's what I just saw. So anyway, yes, there we go. Yeah, that's weird. It keeps taking it away. Okay, so I guess it can only grow on top of grass. So anyway, there we go. That is awesome. And yeah, I know I keep saying that I'm going to give a level download and I'm going to complete this island in the sky. But I will. It's very, very close now, guys. I mean, really all we have left to do is decorate or place the ores inside the cave and on the outside and fix that hole that I left. That's really, really frustrating. And yeah, that actually is all we have left to do. So that, I think, because doing that, this like terraforming, I guess you call it, on the bottom took me so long. I did figure out a good, like, or what I thought was a pretty good system in doing it. It took a while to figure it out, but once I figured it out, it made things a lot easier. Or I guess it made things seem faster is, I guess, what I should say. No, not seem faster. They were faster. This is not very easy to go up anymore. Ugh. There it is. Okay. I'm in. Okay. So, yeah. So, I'm going to ride this up to the top. And, yeah. So, anyway, this is almost done. Now that I think about it, with the hassle that went into making that, I probably should have put the oars in. I may not put the oars on the outside of the island. Maybe a couple, like, I don't know, diamond and stuff. Just to, you know, when you're coming up or looking at it from far away, you can see a little bit of diamond or, you know, a little peak of it. But I'm not going to, like, put coal all around it and stuff like I would inside the cave, because it's just too hard, guys. Like, it's really hard. I mean, if I, it's a survival series, so I can't, but, if I were to switch into creative and do it, I don't even know. It might still be hard, but, it would be a lot easier because I wouldn't have to. The problem with this whole thing is that basically anything you do here, you kind of have to have a floor underneath you. So you have to, like, put a floor down, do a couple things, then get rid of the floor and then move up. Like, it's, well, move up and then get rid of the floor, that sort of thing. And it really does take up a ton of time. Let's see how this looks here. This makes my, like, entrance and exit so much slower. Okay, but I like it. And yeah, this ender chest, I don't even know why I brought it up here, but I gotta get my silk touch pickaxe because I don't want to waste it. But I'll get that. Well, I guess I brought it because of the dragon egg. Anyway, that's it for this episode, guys. Stay tuned for the next one when we finish the Sky Island and I finally give you that level download, world download that you guys have been begging for quite a few episodes. So promise next time, promise that you guys will get it. We'll finish this thing off. And wow, what a project. Seriously, this is probably so far it's the biggest project and probably may be the biggest project I ever take on. So far it is, but maybe of all time, like I may never take on a project this big again. Just because, like, building things in the sky, not advisable, guys. I'll see you guys again soon. Thanks for watching. And of course, noodle on.